Today we are going to make mushroom cutlets. These are high in protein and because they are shallow fried, they are very less oily. At the same time, very crispy and soft inside. Before we start with the recipe, if you have not subscribed to my channel, please click the red subscribe button and hit the bell icon to get all the notification. For this recipe, we need one onion, nicely cut it and peel it and chop it in. To fine pieces. To easily cut the onion in fine pieces, first cut gently like this from the side and chop it, and you can see you can easily get finely chopped onion. Take 15 to 20 mushrooms. Here I am taking button mushrooms. If you have any different variety of mushrooms, you can even use that. To wash mushroom, always add flour on it. Here I am adding whole wheat flour. You can use all purpose flour or corn flour also, and gently toss the mushroom. And then to wash the dirt away, just wash the flour and clean it. If you wash in this way, your mushrooms will not absorb a lot of water because the mushroom is already high in water content. Your dish will not be too liquidy and we can easily dry the cutlets also. So whenever you are washing mushroom, you can try using this way. Once you wash it, drain it in a strainer. Use kitchen towel or tissue paper and pat dry the mushrooms. In this way, the extra moisture content will be removed easily. And now we have to finely chop the mushrooms in this way. And next thing which we need for this is chickpeas, which I have boiled it and cooked with salt and turmeric. Cook it for around 4 to 5 whistles so that they mash easily. We will be using chickpeas as a binding agent instead of potato for this cutlet, this which will make our cutlet very high in protein content. You have to make it into a thin paste like this. Add as less water as possible. Now add at least 2 tablespoons of oil in a pan and add finely chopped onion and fry it till they turn into golden brown. When you saute the onions, add a vegetable stock. It will give a nice flavor to your cutlet. Once the onion turns into golden brown, add mushroom pieces and saute it well. For this cutlet, we need to saute the mushroom well with the onion. That's because onion and mushroom both are very high in water content. At the same time, mushroom is very good source of protein for vegetarians. Once the mushroom is sauteed, add some red chili powder, turmeric powder, garam masala powder, and some black pepper, a and mix it well. Those who like spicy cutlet can add green chilies. Now you can see our mushroom is almost dry. So that's the time when you have to transfer this mushroom and onion to a bowl and let it cool down. And once it's cooled, add our chickpea paste. This will act as a binding agent. Here we are not using any potato, so chickpea is the binding agent and it is a high source of protein as well as fiber. And add some cashews, which will give a nice crunch. You can even add walnut or almonds too. Here I am adding half a cup of breadcrumbs and mix everything well, first with a spoon. Once everything is mixed well with the spoon, you can start mixing it with your hand. Mix it nicely and let the breadcrumbs and chickpea paste and the mushroom onion paste get mixed well. Once you have mixed well, make a small ball out of the dough and see if it's binding well. If it's binding well, that's sufficient. If it's not binding well and if it's watery, add some more breadcrumbs. It will soak up the water. Now take a big roll and give a shape of your cutlet. Generally, when I make cutlet at home, I make few extra cutlets and freeze it in the freezer with the help of butter paper in between each cutlet. And whenever I need to make a burger or when I need a quick starter, I use these burger patties. You can place the cutlets in between your butter paper like this and freeze it in the freezer. It goes well for around a month. Now take a pan, add some oil and let shallow fry few cutlets. If you want, you can even shape them as small nuggets and you can shallow fry them. I prefer shallow frying over deep frying because all the ingredients are already cooked, and once it turns golden brown, you can just flip it over. And when both the sides are golden brown, take it in a plate and remove the extra oils with tissue paper. Now we can see our yummy cutlets are ready, which is crisp outside. At the same time, it's very soft inside. So if you have liked this recipe, please give a big thumbs up and like, share and subscribe to my channel.